Okay, so this is probably going to be the first part of a series on this drill press. I've made some videos. As a matter of fact, I just finished filming a clip about that hole in the base plate that has got, will be and has gone up on shop update videos. But I saw these attachment bolts underneath the paint for this housing here. So what I'm in the process of doing right now is I had to scrape they're cap head screws actually, and I had to scrape a bunch of paint, dirt, etc. out of them to be able to get a nail and wrench into them. Okay, the bracket for I'm not going to be taking that off right now. The bracket for the electrical box is actually attached to that cover plate. I thought it was attached behind the cover plate where the housing where the cover plate is mounted to, but it's not. It's attached to the cover plate. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pull that electrical box loose and let it hang there, pull that cover plate off afterwards. So, but I'll bring it back. Okay, so there is the cover plate off. And here it is on the table. Kind of dirty inside. Logically, that's the inside. And you can see, when I got this thing from Adam, he says he never recalls this side that didn't have the spindle feed on it, which is the right-hand side. He doesn't remember that ever working, but you can clearly see where it has operated, because you can see the buildup where the pulleys probably threw dirt off, or grease, or it's just caked on dirt. But you can see the striations in the housing where it spun and threw it out onto the housing. I've got to wash that off. I mean, that's like grease. Yeah, I'll scrape it off over a barrel first and then wash it off. Probably put it in the...
I'm going to throw this clip into this video regarding the drill press. And it's going to be a kind of a lesson learned experience for everybody as to things that were told to me that I didn't really take good note of. So I'm going to be saying some things. I'm going to let the videos play out, the clips in the videos play out as they are, but I'm going to say some things referencing that I'm not sure of what some things are for, or I didn't understand the speed of the two heads when the belt was on the same pulley arrangement. So, and let it play out as it is, and then at the end I'm going to put a clip in and kind of explain a conversation that I had with Adam today, and how that I'm kind of an idiot for not remembering something. So let it play out.
I had to go out to Home Depot to pick something up today, and while I was there I picked up some four conductor cable for to run to the drill press. Now what it is 12, which is rated for good for 20 amps, and these motors only draw, well, there's two ratings on it, and I'm not really sure their initial ratings. One is 6.8 and the other 7.3, so let's say at the worst case factor it draws 8 amps, so the cable should be good, the cord should be good. I'm going to hook them up. I've got to run out a little bit in a little bit too with the metal supply warehouse, but I'm going to, when I come back, I'm going to try and hook up the one drill press, this one, the one on the left-hand side, that's still got the automatic feed on it. I'll try and get that hooked up when I come back, but I've got to, I've got some other things that I've got to do too, so I'll show you that in a minute.
Just a quick shot, this electrical box on the drill press. Going to start hooking up the wiring. It's going to be permanent wiring, but I've made the lead that comes into it long enough that I can power it up while it's over here out in the center of the floor before, you know, I start painting and cleaning and painting and etc. on this thing. I just kind of wanted to power it up and make sure it runs okay. So if it doesn't, I can address that issue before I get it set back in place. Okay guys, so I got the wiring over to the power supply. I actually started to wire the secondary one too, but I wanted to get it, I wanted to wire the primary lead in and to see if it ran. And here goes. Hopefully you can see that. Gotta tell you, I'm really happy. Got a little dust off of it when I first started it up, but you know, besides that, that's great. It's really quiet. Good strong machine. I'm really happy. I'll bring you back as I do some more on it.
It's going to be a couple of things I want to show you here on the drill press. Today's Tuesday. I said in the previous video or one of the previous videos that I had gotten the belt for the other side of the drill press, the right hand side. And I did, I got it on. I had to, this lever actually is on a cam like roller there. It's not a roller, it's just a piece of round steel, but it's cammed, so it's offset. So you just pull that lever down, which was a little hard, kind of painted and everything, but pull that lever down, it tilts the motor back in so that you can get the belt on, and it goes on fairly easily. Wouldn't go on fairly easy if the guard was on there, but it went on pretty easy because I've got the guards off to clean, and I've got one of them over in the blast cabinet. So anyways, let me show it to you. What I did is I put that one on slightly on a different pulley arrangement. So it's just, it should be just a little bit faster than this one. Let's see if we can start this one up too. Actually, it looks slower. That shouldn't be. But anyways, it's on. I can adjust it. For some reason, there is seems to be a little shaking in this one. Watch when I shut it off. Yeah, it could be just the bearings. Let me, I'm going to try and, I just threw some oil in there. So, I'm going to grease it and oil it and, see what's going on with it. I
don't think the shaft is bent. It didn't look like, let me shut this one off. It didn't look like there was any deviation in No, I can't feel anything. I mean, I think that wobbling is coming from up above. I noticed when I didn't have it, maybe it's just because the belt hasn't been run in so long, but I'll check it out. I'll get back there, make sure that all of that stuff is greased and oiled, and see if that makes any difference.
This is the belt guard off of the drill press. I just wanted to show you, I cleaned it out. Now, I don't know whether I showed you another picture of this before, but this thing was caked with dirt. As a matter of fact, I kind of saved it. That all came out of the inside of the belt guard. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull off the other one and clean that one out too, because I kind of stuck my finger in there and it's kind of the same way. Now, I think it's there is a lot of rubber from the belt actually in there, but I think, you know, probably rubber got thrown up there and then grease stuck to it. Typical machine shop type of dust, dirt, grease, rubber from the belt. But I'm going to take the other one off, clean that out, then I'm going to take them out, power wash them, throw them in the bead blaster, and clean them up. But I'll bring you back. So here's the other belt guard off. I got to tell you, this one is not nearly as dirty as the first one was. The one off, I'm calling it the secondary side, the side that is on the right or doesn't have the power feed. One of the things is I found this bolt, it's threaded, kind of curved on one side, flat on the other side. I'm sorry, not a bolt, a nut. Okay, so I have no idea where I left off. Somebody came in and I got interrupted, but what I'm going to do is clean this one up like I did the other one. Scrape it out. I'll power wash them out and then take them and put them in the bead blaster and clean up the paint. Get as much of the paint off as I can and get ready to paint them.
But I said that I was going to go out and power wash the belt guards, but what I ended up doing actually is I put them in the parts washer and washed them because they were so dirty. It was kind of a miserable day yesterday too, but over here at the blast cabinet, I've got the one in there. Just started it actually, so I'll bring you back. So this is the belt guard cover plate that I've got out of the bead blaster. And one of the things that somebody had told me is that one of the coats on the original coats on that the casting is a filler material to cover, fill in the roughness of the cast iron. And I've got to tell you, this thing is pretty rough. It probably doesn't pick it up in the video, but it is really rough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to
try a sample of, put some primer paint on it and see what it looks like. And then decide how I'm going to handle the rest of it. Logically, all I have is a blast cabinet, so I couldn't blast the base or the bigger portions of it, but let me see how this turns out after being blasted and all the coats removed. I'll bring you back. So I didn't show you the primer coat that I put on. I put a coat of gray primer over it and then painted it flat black. As you can see, I put some gold accent on those ribbed casting protrusions. Kind of what I think I'm going to do is paint these covers black and then paint the rest of the main part of the drill press gray. It's going to not be that shiny gray, but it's going to be a flat gray. And then what I will do is probably accent some of it with black. I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I've got to get it cleaned up first. So that's a major thing. I want to get it cleaned up. All of that chipped and peeling paint off of it, and then get a coat of I'll put a coat of primer and a coat of I'm not sure if I'm going to go with flat gray or semi-gloss gray. I'll decide that, and then I'll decide what I'm going to accent. Probably the handles are going to be maybe a different color, and I'll probably do some accenting with black on the base of it, but I'll bring you back for it. We're back over here at the drill press, and one of the things that I've been working on, as you may have noticed in the other video, that when I fired this thing up, this left-hand side runs very quietly. And what I think the reason is this spindle is turning with a pulley. Now, let me take you over to the other side. And I'm going to start it up, and I'm going to start it up and shut it off because it's making a lot more grinding noise than it did before. But let me do it. So, as you'll notice, this spindle isn't turning. Now, let me get you around here and show you. There's a pin in here that's engaged by this lever, and you push this lever back and it pulls that pin back. Well, and let me back off of here and show you over here. On this side, it's engaged. Now, I think Adam told me that those pins are to go in there so that you can lock that hub when you're changing the belt or something, or lock the hub so that it doesn't spin. But anyways, as you can see, the lever mechanism is missing off of this one, but I've loosened this up. That bolt is loose, and I can't get that pin to push back out of there. So that's one of the things that I'm working on right now, trying to get that pin out, and hopefully once that pin is out and that thing is free, that spindle is free to turn with a pulley, it's going to eliminate all of those noises and that gear grinding kind of sounds out of it. But I'll bring you back, let you know how I make out. So I'm talking about not remembering. Have any of you guessed it yet? I've
talked about the speeds of the belts on the pulleys and that pin, thinking what that pin was. Have any of you guessed what that pin does? I made a couple of other clips and I'm not going to put them in this segment. I'm going to install them in part two probably. That's where it's going to begin. But that pin is not to lock the things. And Adam told me that when I picked the drill press up. That pin engages a back gear. That is why that one, the one on your right, my left as I'm standing right now, runs slower and has that noise, because it's the planetary gears of the back gear. Back gear engages, it provides more torque into the spindle, so it has a back gear on it. I have no idea why the hell I didn't remember that. I mean, there was a lot going on that day, loading the stuff, unloading the next day for Keith, his drill press. And as soon as Adam told me that today, I remembered it distinctly. I remember standing on the trailer looking at that thing and him telling me that it was to engage a back gear. Why I didn't remember it before now, I have no idea. But such is life. But anyways, that's why the one on your right, my left, makes more noises, because the back gear is engaged on that one. Where the other one, it's not engaged on it. So I'm going to be, the next part two is going to be starting with me working on trying to free those pins up. Well, actually, right now I'm only working on the one on your right, my left, trying to get that one, and I can't get it to budge at all. So, well, I can get it to budge, but I mean, I can't get it to come out. But I'll keep working on it and let you know if I get both the back gears working on both spindles. So that's it. End of part one.